Hi, I'm Jilly from Baby Sleep Made Simple. Today we are going to talk about how you can stop co-sleeping or sharing a bed with your baby and instead get them sleeping in the crib all night long. If you want to see my detailed guide on transitioning out of co-sleeping, you can get that on my website right here. This video is for you if your little one is younger than 2 years old and cannot climb out of the crib yet. So maybe you've been co-sleeping for just a few days, a few weeks, a few months, or for your little one's entire existence. But if they are younger than two, I highly recommend that you get them sleeping in a crib for sleep. And the reason why is cribs keep our little ones safely contained while they're sleeping and while we adults are sleeping and can't be supervising them. You will get so much peace of mind knowing that your baby is safely sleeping in a crib and not wandering around their room or the house while you are asleep yourself. So if your little one's younger than two, please try to get them sleeping in a crib. If your little one's 2 to 2.5 years old and you're not exactly sure, just put them in the crib for a little while awake and see if they know how to climb out. And even if they're two but they can't climb out of the crib yet, I highly recommend you transition to the crib now. It could get you 6 more months of peaceful sleep, maybe even up to a year. Now, if your little one is 2.5 or older, or you know that they can climb out of the crib, because that's probably how you got in the co-sleeping situation in the first place, then you're gonna wanna check out my video on how to get your toddler to transition from co-sleeping to a toddler bed, and you can find that right here. I have two approaches for transitioning out of co-sleeping. I've got a gradual approach and a quick approach. So we'll go over the gradual approach first. There are 3 steps to this approach. The first step is all you want to focus on is sleeping with just a little bit of distance between you and your baby for a few nights. So when you're co-sleeping and sharing your bed, you and your baby are like this, right? Like sardines in a can. You're probably touching each other all night long, and your little one has gotten used to being able to touch you to be able to sleep well. So all you're gonna do for the first night or two is get your baby to sleep however you normally do, and then once they're asleep, you're gonna scoot about 1 foot away from them in the bed, and then you're gonna sleep as long as you possibly can. If they wake up later in the night, help them back to sleep as you always have. Once you know they're asleep, you're gonna scoot about 1 foot away from them in the bed. Really, really simple concept, but it can really make the difference with that first step of getting your baby used to sleeping with a little bit of space around them rather than being pressed into you in the night. So once you've spent a few nights sleeping with a bit of distance between you and your little one, step two is you're gonna put your baby's crib next to your bed. You can use a traditional crib, or you can use a travel crib or a travel cot if you don't have much room in your bedroom. Travel cribs like the Pack and Play or the Guava Lotus, these are all safe for babies to sleep in. If you have a really young baby, like a newborn, you could transition them to a bassinet next to your bed. So this would be a baby that's 3 months or younger. So you wanna get them their own safe contained sleep space right next to your bed. Okay, so how you make step two work is you're gonna slowly get your little one used to sleeping in a new space, but without them really realizing it. So what you're gonna do is very similar to step one. You're gonna get your baby to sleep however you normally have gotten them to sleep, whether feeding, rocking, lying down together. And then once you know they're asleep, you're gonna very, very carefully pick them up and gingerly put them in the crib to sleep there. The idea here is you're just getting your baby used to sleeping in a new space. We're not going for 12 hours in the crib on the first night. That would be amazing if it happens, but we're not aiming for that. We're aiming for 1 hour of crib time on night one. If you get that, that's a win. Celebrate. On night two, we're going for 3 hours in the crib. On night three, we're gonna go for 5 hours. We're slowly increasing your little one's time in the crib so they can get used to sleeping there. Of course, your little one will probably still wake in the night. You're gonna have to do as you did before, take them out of the crib, help them back to sleep, wait for them like 10 minutes after they've fallen asleep, you know they're in a nice, good, deep sleep, and then again, try to transition them to the crib and then just remove your support and go to sleep yourself. For some little ones, they'll instantly sleep a few hours in the crib the first night, which is amazing. Other little ones may try to wake up every time you put them in the crib. You just gotta be extra patient and really work on this. And within a few days, you will see your little one accept some amount of time in the crib. And please celebrate this, because already you've made such a huge accomplishment, sleeping a little bit farther from your baby and now getting them used to spending some amount of time in the crib. If you feel like things are going well and you want a little bit more distance between you and your little one, you can take the crib or the travel crib and you can push it a few feet away from your bed as well. That can help you guys not wake each other up all night long. Step three is to begin sleep training. The best way to get your baby or toddler to accept and happily sleep in the crib all night long is to teach them to sleep there independently. If you're able to help your baby fall asleep at bedtime, place them in the crib and they sleep there all night long without issue, that's great. You don't have to do this step. But for a lot of little ones, they're going to continue waking during the night. They're going to continue needing help falling back asleep. You may find your little one starts rejecting the crib more after a few nights, and you may find just out of exhaustion and desperation, you pull them back into the bed with you and you're back at square one. So this is the perfect time to begin sleep training. Sleep training is the process of teaching your little one to sleep independently. And what that means is we work on getting your baby to accept falling asleep on their own at bedtime in the crib and resettling themselves each time they wake during the night. And when you're able to do this, you will see within a matter of a few days, or maybe a few weeks, your little one happily goes into the crib awake at bedtime. You know, kiss, kiss, lullaby, you leave the room. They fall asleep easily and they sleep through the night and they resettle themselves if they wake during the night. This is totally possible once your baby is 5 months old or older. So if you would like any help or more explanations, step-by-step guides, personal support with sleep training, you can check out my program called 21 Days to Peace and Quiet here. You can see the link. But really, you could choose any sleep training method at this point. And as long as you have a clear guide on what you're going to do and you can stay consistent, you will see big results and a big improvements in your little one's sleep and with them accepting staying in the crib all night long. You can sleep train with baby in your bedroom, or if you'd like your baby to sleep in a separate bedroom, then I recommend you move them into their bedroom when you begin sleep training. Okay, now let's talk about the quick approach. So this method is where you start sleep training your little one and transitioning to the crib at the same time. So you don't take those initial few nights to get them used to sleeping in a new space without them really realizing it. Instead, with the quick approach, what you're going to do is you're going to start sleep training on night one by placing your little one in the crib awake at bedtime and having them stay there all night long while you choose a sleep training method and you stay consistent. The quick approach works really well for babies that just don't accept the gradual approach. So the ones that I mentioned that wake up every single time you try to put them in the crib all night long for several nights. If that's happened to you, then I recommend you take the quick approach. Also, if your little one is really active, so rolling, scooting, crawling, or walking like crazy, and you're up all night worrying about them, you know, falling off the bed, rolling off the bed, walking off the bed, then the quick approach is the way to go. It's also a really good option for parents who are just at the end of their rope. They're beyond exhausted and they need to get their little one sleeping in the crib ASAP. So with the quick approach, all you're going to do is pick a sleep training method, one that you feel comfortable with, make sure you have a clear guide, pick a time that you know you're highly motivated and you know you can stay consistent, and then just get going from night one. Because there's no warming up period where your little one's not kind of getting used to the crib, as you may expect, there's going to be some resistance, there's going to be frustration on your baby's part, there's going to be fussiness, and there's more than likely going to be crying. But with sleep training, as long as you can stay committed to the steps and stay consistent, you will see big, big improvements in your little one's sleep in just a matter of a few days. Okay, guys, there you have it. Those are the steps to transitioning out of co-sleeping or sharing a bed with your baby and transitioning him to the crib all night long. You can take a few days to do the gradual approach, or you can just hit the ground running from day one with the quick approach. If you have any questions, please post in the comments below and make sure you check out BabySleepMadeSimple.com where you can get lots of free resources to help you with your baby's sleep.